This program was paid for by Water of Life Church. From Water of Life Ministries in Plano, Texas, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob is speaking through his servants to the world. He that hath ears to hear, let him hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying today. Let us join Doyle Davidson and others of Water of Life, sowing the Word of God in spirit and in truth.
Hello, I'm Doyle Davidson, servant and apostle of the Lord Jesus Christ, ministering locally to the body of Christ in Dallas, Fort Worth, Christ, Texas, sent by God to your house to declare unto you the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. Thank God, 1 Corinthians 15, 3 and 4, tell us what the gospel is, how that Jesus Christ died for our sins, according to Scripture. He is buried, he rose again, third day, according to the Scripture. Thank God. Amen. Amen. Thank God. Thank God. Thank God. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me. He's anointed me. Preach the gospel to the poor. Sent me healed. Broken hearted. Preach deliverance. Captives. Go to sight to the blind. Send the liberty. Them that are bruised. Amen. Amen. Thank God. Amen. What is nothing? If in your heart, in your mouth, there's a word of faith, which I preach, you confess with your mouth, the Lord Jesus, believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you shall be saved with the heart, man, believeth unto righteousness, with the mouth, confession is made unto salvation. Thank God. Amen. Thank God. Amen. Thank God. I'm about to shake the gospel of Christ. There's a power of God unto salvation. Everyone believe it. Jew first, also to the Greek. There, the righteousness of God revealed from faith to faith, as it is written, the just shall live by his faith. Well, I welcome you to this broadcast, receiving it. Thank God. A live stream, broken for Apple TV, YouTube, as a device. Thank God. Kathie Davidson, my goals. To my left, good morning. How are you?
Doing well.
Amen. Thank God. Amen. There is some resistance.
Just a little.
So, I'd like to start with Terre Brown's recording song, Adoration Goes Straight. I can't do what I thought I was going to do.
All right.
Holy unto your Praise to the one who sent us his son. Praise.
and doubt come against your mind? Has your faith been so?
We'll get very far when you'll find me.
give a joyous shout in the honor of the rock of our salvation. Come before him with thankful hearts. Let us sing him songs of praise. Hallelujah.
till now, we've been looking through a glass so dark and dim, and only a few mysteries have we known. But I sense now,
yeah. the night. The darkness overtaken by a bright and shining light. Oh, I couldn't understand it. I couldn't reason how. Then my eyes beheld him, and I wasn't dreaming now. And I saw the Lord. He was high and lifted up, and rightfully adored. And I saw the Lord. He saw me. I saw the Lord. He was high and lifted up, and rightfully
Black boys. Kathie Davidson is coming. She's not going to come far. She's sitting right here. Amen. Amen. Appreciate your preaching of the gospel.
You ready for some more?
Yes.
All right.
I can't talk anymore. Would you go?
Yes. I'm going to minister to some of us today that might just help some of you. If we will go to Romans 8, verse 1. It says, there is therefore now no condemnation, no guilt. There is therefore now no condemnation, no feeling condemned, no guilt to them which are in Christ Jesus. To them which are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. Amen. There is therefore no condemnation, no feeling condemned, no guilt for them that are in Christ Jesus. But you say you have a struggle with this. You have some things that condemn you. You know, the devil's really good at it. The devil knows exactly what the buttons are to push, and he knows exactly which one to push on you, and then you feel condemned, and you feel ashamed, and you feel guilt. Well, I'm going to help you today if you will listen to these words that God asked me to minister to you. You know, it says those that are in Christ Jesus. And you say, well, then you got to first be in Christ Jesus. Well, how can you be in Christ Jesus? It says in Ephesians 3, it says that Christ may dwell in your hearts by faith. By faith. Now, don't get all freaked out with the word faith like I used to. Doyle would say it's by faith, and I would go, oh, I don't have any faith. My faith won't work. It would get me upset. And one day God said, do you lie in that bed every night and wonder if the sun's going to come up in the morning? Well, no. Why not? Because you have faith that the sun's going to come up in the morning. Do you know you have faith that the sun's going to come up in the morning? Well, you say, well, of course, it's going to come up every morning. Do you know that the word of God is stronger than the sun? 1,000 times stronger than the sun, and it's the word of God that put the sun there. And it's the word of God that makes that sun come up every morning.
Amen.
Now, put your trust and your faith in the word of God, just like you put your faith and trust in the sun. Now, let's go back to this. There is now, therefore, no more condemnation to those that are in Christ Jesus. Well, how do you overcome that condemnation? Go with me to Isaiah 53:6. I'm going to help you. I'm going to give you something to meditate on, to trust in, to hang on to. Isaiah 53, verse 6. All we like sheep, every one of us, like sheep have gone astray. You see what that verse says? Every one of us screwed up. Every one of us have messed up. Every one of us. Do you see what that says? All we like sheep have gone astray. Yeah, and it says we have turned everyone to his own way. Every one of us have messed up. Every one of us are in sin. That's what the word of God says. So what do we do? And the Lord laid on him, on Jesus. And the Lord laid on Jesus, had it meet on him, laid on Jesus the iniquity of us all. Do you see what the word of God says here? It says the Father, Jehovah, laid on Jesus when he was on the cross, put on Jesus the iniquity of us all. Put it on him. Do you know that it is written in the Bible that there's proof of this? There's proof that God laid this on Jesus? Did you know there's proof? Turn with me to Psalm 31. I'm going to show you what happens when iniquity comes on a person. And our iniquity, all our sin, God put on Jesus. Jesus said it himself. God put it on Jesus. God took our iniquity, our sin, and he laid it on the body of Jesus and in his soul when Jesus was on the cross. That's what the word of God says. Jesus, the word of God says, he who knew no sin became sin. How? The Father took what you and I did, and he put it on the body of Jesus. Put it on his body. Look with me to Psalm 31. I'm going to begin in verse 9. It says, have mercy on me, O Lord, for I am in trouble. Mine eye is consumed because of with grief. Yea, my soul and my belly. And look, for my life is spent with grief, and my years with sighing. My strength faileth. Look at this. My strength faileth because of mine iniquity. Because of my iniquity, my strength faileth. Because of sin, I have no strength. Do you see that? Because of sin, I have no strength. Now, if you look it up in the translation, the literal translation, the word mine isn't there. It is not there in Strong's. So it's just talking about iniquity. This very well could be Jesus. But if it's not Jesus, it still shows you what happens when there's sin on a body, when there's iniquity. It says, my strength faileth because of mine iniquity. And look at this next phrase. And my bones are consumed. And my bones are consumed. If you look that word consumed up, do you know what it's talking about? Do you know what it means? I studied it out. Yes, I study the word of God. And I studied it out. And I looked it up in Jacenesis lexicon. And it means it's talking about used clothes that fall to pieces. Clothes, old clothes that fall to pieces. It means to fall away, not to consume, to fall away. That's what happens to bones when there's iniquity on them, lots of iniquity. They fall away. What happened to Jesus on the cross? What happened to Jesus on the cross? Go back with me to Isaiah 52, verse 14.
Thank God.
What happens when you put iniquity on a body? When there's a lot of iniquity there, the bones are consumed. They fall away. They fall away. Isaiah 52, 14. As many were astonished at thee, his visage, his face was marred more than any man, and his form more than the sons of men. Jesus lost his form because every bone went out of joint. Because those bones went out of joint. You've got guilt. I want you to look at that body. I want you to look at that body. I want you to meditate on that body. I want you to consider that body. I want you to talk about what that body looked like on the cross with your sin on it, with the thing that bothers you every day on it. I want you to look at what that body on the cross looked like. Go with me to Psalm 22. I'm going to begin in verse 14. This also is Jesus on the cross. And this also shows what happened when that iniquity went on him. The Roman soldiers couldn't put every bone out of joint. Iniquity did. Iniquity put every bone of Jesus out of joint. Amen. Verse 14, Jesus on the cross, I am poured out like water, and all my bones are out of joint. My heart is like wax. It is melted in the midst of my bowels. And 15, my strength is dried up like a potsherd. What did we see in Psalm 31? When iniquity's there, the strength goes. No strength. And the bones fall away. They fall apart. They fall apart. That's what iniquity does. And that's what iniquity, your iniquity, did to Jesus. Yours, the thing that bothers you day and night, that's what did it to Jesus. That's why that bone, those bones look like they did. That's why Jesus looked like they did. Do you see that that thing you did is not on you anymore? It went on the body of Jesus. It says, my strength is dried up like a potsherd, and my tongue cleaveth to my jaws. And thou hast brought me into the dust of death. For dogs have compassed me. The assembly of the wicked have enclosed me. They pierced my hands and my feet. That shows this is Jesus. And it says, I may tell all my bones, they look and stare upon me. That's what our iniquity did to Jesus. That's what the thing you did to Jesus. The Father took it from you and he put it on that body of Jesus because he loved you and he wanted that sin taken care of, and he couldn't get you back to him until he dealt with that sin, until he took it away from you. And the only way to take it from you was that somebody had to take it. Somebody had to pay for it. The wages of sin is death, and somebody had to die. And he put it on the only person that could do it. The only person, the only man that could handle it and take it and pay for it and then be raised again the third day. And that was Jesus. When you feel that guilt, amen, when that condemnation comes up in your heart, start meditating on what that body looked like for that sin that's condemning you. Start looking at it. Start considering it. Start speaking it. Start meditating on it. Start thanking God for what it looked like. Start asking God or telling God, that's where my sin went. Start boasting that's what Jesus did for you. Boasting that Jesus' bones were out of joint for that sin that you committed. And when you keep doing that, your faith will grow in that, because faith comes by hearing the gospel. And when you speak that, and when you consider it, meditate on it, trust in it, that sin will go where it needs to go, where it was made to go. That sin will go away from you down to the bottom of the sea, and it won't bother you another day. It will not bother you another day. How do I know that? Because I have sin that is gone. I'm justified from, and it does not bother me because it is not there.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. We ready for a song?
Yes, we are.
Thank God. Thank God. Thank God, thank God, thank God in prayer. Thank God.
I'm only human. I'm just a woman. Help me believe in what I can be and all that I am. Show me the stairway I have to climb. Lord, for my sake, teach me to take one day at a time. One day at a time. Sweet Jesus, that's all I'm asking from you. Give me the strength to do everything that I have to do. Do you remember when you walked among men? Jesus, you know when you're looking below, it's worse now than then. Cheating and teach me to take one day at a time. One day at a time. Sweet Jesus, that's all I'm asking from you. Give me the strength to do every day what I have to do.
Terre Brown. No other day. No other day under heaven whereby one must be saved. Just one. No other day. Just one. Jesus Christ of Nazareth. You've got the faith in your heart. That the grace with it. It's written in the Word. You must be saved. Born again, one with Jesus. Speak the name after me, Jesus, and be saved.
Jesus.
God bless.
We invite you to visit Water of Life Church at 1621 18th Street in Plano, Texas. Or for further information, call area code 972-578-8082. That's 972-578-8082. Or write Doyle Davidson, Post Office Box 861327, Plano, Texas 75086. That's Doyle Davidson, Post Office Box 861327, Plano, Texas 75086. This program was paid for by Water of Life Church.